Hey folks, this is Best in Slot. Welcome back to our Mods of the Week Spotlight series for Jurassic World Evolution 2. We've got 8 mods to take a look at today, some cool decorations, 4 brand new species, and some new twists on existing hybrids. Very cool stuff. Before we dig into all that, a disclaimer: as per usual, mods can cause problems with your game. They can possibly break your save files, all that kind of jazz. If they do break your game, it's not my fault, it's not the mod maker's fault, and most importantly, it's not Frontier's fault. Use at your own risk, but you should be okay. But you never know. For example, I'm not okay, can't load my old save files. But I do uninstall and reinstall a bajillion mods every week because of this series. So let's get started with some of our brand new dinosaurs for today. And there we go. This is Valibona venatrix by Hassan Wackatree. Should mention, as per usual, all mods will be linked in the description down below. Just go into the Google document and you'll find all of this week's mods and all the other mods we've highlighted along the way. So this beautiful, quite small Spinosaurus, you would say. We're going to take another look at something very cool in just a second for this, but Valibona venatrix is an early Cretaceous Spinosaurid from Spain. Discovered sometimes in the early 1990s, it wasn't officially named and described until 2019. It took near enough 30 years for this thing to get a full proper name and description, which is crazy. And again, makes me wonder, you know, what dinosaurs are out there just waiting to be described. And it was eventually named for the nearby town of Valibona, and venatrix, of course, which is the Latin for huntress, which is, you know, kind of baller, really. This is actually the most complete Spinosaurid from the Iberian Peninsula, and it's still only known from a single fragmentary skeleton, so we don't have great skeletons for Spinosaurids from the Iberian Peninsula, as you can kind of figure out. But brilliantly brought to life by Hassan Wackatree, which is one of my favorite names to say. Really cool to see one of these sort of smaller Spinosaurids. We've got that slight paddle tail going on there. It's kind of thick there. It's not a full-on paddle tail, but it's a semi-paddle tail. Looks more akin to, say, the Baryonyx and stuff like that in formation. It's got a little Spinosaurus. It's got a little Baryonyx. It's got this really interesting dappled pattern along the body and then along the spine there as well. We've got that little crest on top as well. And, of course, that very crocodilian-looking mouth shape you would expect from a Spinosaurid. Got some really interesting colors as well. This thing comes with a gajillion different color options, which is really cool. You want to install the color core mod to make sure you can access it and get all these various options, which, as you can see, tons of variety in the colors on this thing. And a beautiful way to start the day. Shout out to Hassan Wackatree. It's a fantastic name. However, as a very cool bonus, you can see we also have an aquatic version included as part of the same mod. Very cool stuff. So you can have your swimming lagoon Spinosaurid and you can have your terrestrial Spinosaurid as well. And they've all got the same like huge suite of skin colors. So if you wanted, you could pick the exact right ones to match between, you know, your terrestrial and your swimming versions, if you wanted to kind of pretend your terrestrial ones were going for a swim, which is very cool. But just very cool to see your swimming Spinosaurus as well. I love when mod makers do this. We're seeing this quite a lot. You know, I'm sure it isn't easy to take this exact same model and put it onto a whole brand new swimming rig. So again, double shout out to Hassan Wackatree. And whilst we're here in the lagoons, let's check out another brand new lagoon species. Go. This beautiful creature is a Temnodontosaurus made by David. I don't know if David wants to go by something else, but that's who they are on the Nexus. David. So Temnodontosaurus, the cutting tooth lizard, is an early Jurassic ichthyosaur, as you can see, although a bit larger than the ichthyosaurus we have in the game, although not as big as Shoney. And like it's from, like basically all ichthyosaurs from Western Europe. Famous, of course, for having gigantic eyeballs, as you can see here, which would have been around 20 centimeters or 8 inches in diameter, believed to be the largest of any animal discovered. And we're not talking relative to body size, we're talking just flat out the biggest eyeballs discovered, which should give you an idea of how humongous these things are, because obviously there were marine creatures much bigger than Temnodontosaurus, so... yeah, it's pretty incredible. That would have made it, of course, a very able hunter. However, because of the angle of the eyes, you can kind of make it out here. The eyes are pointing out. You've got a bit of skin, though, pointing out here. And the eyes are probably tilting a little bit downwards. It has a blind spot right about here. So if you were flying, or probably swimming in the water, more likely, directly over the top of Temnodontosaurus, it would have been incapable of seeing you. So if you wanted to catch one, the best technique would be like a giant crane or something. Just keep that in mind. For some reason. Anyways, first mod I think we've ever seen from David, and it's really cool. I mean, it's basically a scaled up ichthyosaurus, but it works really well. It's obviously had some remodeling going on there. Got this interesting new sort of ringed pattern, which feels very ocean appropriate. You know, it's a little bit like a blue ringed octopus in the way that the pattern looks. Big variety in the colours. Looks really good, rigged really well. Has a little snap at each other, you know, works great. And nice to have a mid-sized sort of ichthyosaur relative to everything else. You can see it's quite small compared to the Volabona venatrix. Yeah, looks fantastic. Loads of beautiful colours. Interesting little pattern. Big old eyeballs. Exactly what you'd want. And very excited to see new people making new species. And we'll actually have another new creator in a little bit. But before then, we must return to the land. You can't join me because I don't have a crane. This bounding, squeaky creature is a Plateosaurus by Hokal1215. Now, before we talk about that, we're gonna release something else. This bounding, squeaky creature is Plateosaurus by Hokal1215. Now, before we talk about this, we're gonna release something else. This bounding, squeaky creature is Plateosaurus by Hokal1215. So, it comes with three different species, and before we take a look at those, we're going to talk about it a little bit. So, Plateosaurus, we've talked a little bit about it fairly recently. We've had a lot of prosauropods lately, which is pretty cool. And we talked about Plateosaurus and the origins of its name, the complicated origins of its name, just the other week. So we're not going to go into that today. Instead, what we're going to talk about today is the very confusing nature, rather appropriately, of Plateosaurus species. I want to point out, when I wrote this, I did not realize it came with three species. So there are three valid species, and that other three we have here. We have... you're not going to tell me, are you? I'm going to show you it in the hatchery instead. So it comes with three body variants. The first one we released was Plateosaurus gracilis. The second was Plateosaurus longiceps. And that larger, heavier set one at the end was Plateosaurus trocingensis. And this is the type species for Plateosaurus. So those are the three sort of largely regarded as valid different species for Plateosaurus. I think there should be in number order. So number four here is oh no, this should be gracilis, and then that's longiceps. It might be the other way around, and then over here we should have trocingensis. Yeah, okay. Anyways, let's talk about these. So some scientists also think that Erlenbergensis and Engelhard T are also valid. Oh, this is on the Cryolophosaurus rig. That's interesting. So there are two other species that people think might also be, you know, possible for Plateosaurus. And some doubt the validity of Gracilis, calling it a metataxon. And this is where I got confused. This rather confusingly means that the material currently assigned to Gracilis could possibly, if this is true, doesn't belong to a single species, but also doesn't belong to multiple species. Okay? I've been trying to wrap my head around this, and I think this is why this is the case. The holotype for Gracilis, so the holotype is the skeleton in which on which Gracilis was originally described. You know, they discovered this skeleton and they thought, oh, hey, that's a new species of Plateosaurus. Let's call it Gracilis, right? So the original holotype skeleton for Gracilis doesn't have a skull. Now, there are other skeletons, other specimens of Gracilis that do have a skull and also have other body parts, you know, so there is some overlap across the two. The problem is the specimens for the rest of Gracilis, as in not the holotype of Gracilis, don't necessarily fit on top or fit coherently with the existing holotype for Gracilis, right? So, if it is a metataxon, the idea is, and someone will correct me on this, but basically we don't know whether it is Gracilis or whether it's not Gracilis or whether it's multiple species or whether it's not multiple species. It is both multiple species and not multiple species, and it both is and isn't Gracilis. Basically, it could be multiple species because it doesn't necessarily fit, but it could also just all be Gracilis. So we don't know, basically. I think that's basically what it means. Someone feel free to correct me on that, but that's how I understood it anyway. Anyways, yeah, so shout out to Hawkal1215. This is a really cool thing to see. I mean, it's just, you can see a lot of contrast between them all here. It's really nice to see this sort of variety amongst a single Gennaro. We've got all these different sizes, even the body posture is different. Some of them are more bipedal. A little bit further back, they would feel a little bit more basal, I suppose, in some ways, whereas this one over here are, this is the type species one, of course, Trossingensis. Trossingensis is leaning more towards being quadrupedal, which of course is where sauropods would have ended up in the end. So a lot of work in this, of course, putting together three separate species that all look coherent as part of a single genera makes for a really cool mixed habitat. And loads of beautiful colour as well. They've all loads of variety. This one's got the striping along the tail, and then we've got this kind of blobby pattern along the neck. And that's the same. If we go over to 9, we've got a thick one here with the spots down the back, and then this kind of rugged pattern all over the body. And if we go back to number 1 for our smallest of the group, who's going to sit in a bloody bush? This one, the most nimble, the most live of them. Again, a spotted pattern, but thicker spots at the front, and then this really interesting banded pattern starting at the back. So a really cool dinosaur, interesting history. There's lots to talk about with Plateosaurus in general. I mentioned in the last video it was the 5th dinosaur that is still valid that was ever described. So Plateosaurus in general has been around for a very long time, and yet still has much debate about it and about the species and all that kind of jazz. And it's been around for over 200 years at this point, so just goes to show you, really, paleontology is an ever-adapting science and art form. One more species to go. Those are always my favourite animations, you know, where it looks like it's only one dinosaur and then the others come bounding out really happily at the end. So this is Rapetosaurus, made by Chocolate. Again, another new creator. So 2 new creators in a single day. Very exciting stuff. Aww. Oh, and it's running. This is a Titanosaurian from late Cretaceous Madagascar, of course famous for a recent appearance in Prehistoric Planet. And as you can see, it isn't particular. I mean, Titanosaurus kind of encompassed many sizes, but on the scale of Titanosaurus, this is quite a small one compared to, you know, what you think of when you think of a Titanosaurian. This would have been about, you know, elephant-sized, something like that, at least in terms of mass. Its name is derived, this is fun facts, from the religion of the native population of Madagascar, the Malagasy. Their deity, they've got a deity called Rapeto, who's this enormous figure who crafted Madagascar itself, you know, and his footprints are canyons and stuff like that. So you can see how, as I believe the only sauropod in Madagascar, Rapeto is huge. You know, it would have been the biggest thing, the biggest creature in Madagascar would have dominated. And although it's not huge for a titanosaur, Madagascar is a relatively small island, so this thing was given the name of this gigantic earth-altering god, which makes a lot of sense. Fun fact, though, about Rapeto, this enormous fun figure, he was married to, I'm going to butcher this, Rasoaleo, the cattle goddess. So he's the goddess of, you know, earth, basically, or like molding the earth, and she's the goddess of cattle. A fine rom-com mix, I think you'll agree. And one day he asked to borrow her cattle because he wanted to trample down some fields. but she refused. They're her cattle. Get your own bloody cattle. We're not going Dutch on the cattle. So, in retaliation, he dammed up the area and turned the grazing fields, which he was hoping to stomp down, into Lake Itasi, or Itasi. Now, this story has been twisted over time to taking place before the marriage did. You know, I've said they were husband and wife. The way that the sort of elders tell it is that they were not yet married because, and the reason for this is because obviously a wife wouldn't have turned down the request of her husband. You're not allowed to disobey your husband even if you're the cattle goddess. Sexism goes all the way to the top. But no more. Now they're married and you know what? I hope that she still keeps her cattle to herself. You tell him, Rasaola. Anyways, yeah, fun facts about Raptosaurus. So, by chocolate, yeah, really interesting to have a new maker in here. And of course, we have this really interesting sort of small to mid-sized sauropod. We don't really have many this size and this shape as well. The smaller ones tend to be more your... I've forgotten the name of every single dinosaur that's ever existed. Your Amargosaurus and that kind of thing, or your Nigerosaurus, which have a more... horizontal, low to the ground sort of body shape, whereas this has a more classic Titanosaurian shape, but it's a lot smaller. It makes it really interesting, and it's yeah, really well done. Again, really interesting patterns, lots of variety in the color schemes and stuff like that. I really like this kind of inky blot pattern we've got along the body there, and it's really interesting along the neck as well. A big mix of coloration there, and then that big strong tail at the back. Really exciting stuff, and really glad to see another creator in as well, making beautiful new dinosaurs. Zoom. Now we do have more dinosaurs to take a look at, but before we do that, we're going to hop over here to the left for another cool mod. So, Scary Face has made two new mods. The first one is these, and these are, of course, the missing enclosure signs that were in Jurassic World Evolution 1, which apparently are still in the files. Or they weren't in the files, but I can't remember what they said. It was something about the files are accessible. So, Scary Face has taken the enclosure signs from Evolution 1 and brought them over to Evolution 2. Why they're not there by default, nobody knows. But we have them now thanks to the mod. So you've got a little bit more variety. You can have your Ankylosaurians, you've got your Ceratopsids, you've got your Brachiosaurus in there, you've got your Pachycephalosaurus over there, etc., etc. Your small carnivore sign, stuff like that. Just a little bit more variety in your sign enclosure choices. However, they then went and made a bunch of their own. So in a separate mod, they now have all of these brand new, very cool sign decorations, all fitting that Jurassic Park style. So you've got like your Abelosaurids or your Carcharodontosaurids, your Dunkleosteus now has its own custom little sign, your hybrids, your Ichthyosaurs and your Pleo and Plesiosaurs, and even one for Synapsids and stuff like that. So, you know, all different colours, all the different body shapes and stuff like that, all the different skull shapes, loads of variety, really cool. Now you can basically, any single exhibit you could think to make, you can now find an appropriate enclosure sign, which I think is really cool. So, shout out to Scary Face for a not-so-scary mod. Finger guns. We are nearly done, but I've got one more mod to show you. I'm going to start... Okay, we're going to have to kill the trees because they've all decided to sit there. So I think a lot of these are ports from Evolution 1 because I do remember some of them, but not all of them. This is the new Stegoceratops variants and the new Spinoraptor variants from Mitchell Productions. And these are variants, so when you go to release the dinosaur, you just click a different body variant. They're all folded in there. It's not a new species, but also... you don't lose anything, you still have the originals, we just have these interesting little variants. So one of them is this horrible thing over here, I'm sorry, it's just my hatred for Jurassic World Alive's, most of their designs. But this is the Mono Stego or something from Jurassic World Alive. I mean, this is what it looks like at the end of the day, it's not Mitchell's fault, this is what it looks like, it's terrifying, it's bizarre. But there's some pretty cool ones. So this one is Kentrosaurus inspired, you can see we've got extra spikes here, particularly on the back and down the tail there. And a little bit on the front elbow. The spines on the Thagomyza as well are more Kentrosaurus shaped, and the plates have been pushed back as well into that Kentrosaurus kind of shape as well. So that one's got a little bit of Kentrosaurus rather than Stegosaurus DNA. Over here, this one is more Nasutoceratops shaped. You can see with the horns there. This shape in particular, this shape screams Nasutoceratops. So that's our Stegosaurus Nasutoceratops hybrid. And this one over here is more based on Styracosaurus, as you can see, which is pretty cool as well. Looks fantastic. So if you wanted a bit of variety in your Stegoceratops, this one and this one in particular with those different head shapes, I think are really cool and kind of fits the weird, glued together, very hybridized nature of these dinosaurs. You could do like a little science facility and have all three of them in like adjacent exhibits, and it would look like they were experimenting with different combinations. I think that's pretty cool. However, even cooler than those is over here. We have the same deal, but this time instead is the Spinoraptor variants. So we have the Carnoraptor, which is returning from Evolution 1. I remember reviewing this mod in Evolution 1 and maybe even Evolution 2, I don't remember, but there you go. So again, these are all variants, so this will go over the top. Well, it'll be an alternate for your Spinoraptor. So we've got a Carnoraptor. Over here, we've got a Baryonyx version. So it would be a Baryraptor, I suppose. You can see there with the colouring, it's much more Baryonyx. Head is thicker and has that kind of weird little indent and colour scheme there that the Baryonyx has. This one is meant to be more Raptor, I think it is. Now, I didn't have a list of these, but I was kind of figuring it out. I think this one is meant to have more of a Raptor shape to it. It's more Velociraptorin. Except it's got the little sail. You know, the head shape is more Raptor than it is Spinosaurus, unlike the Spinoraptor. This one is plus Spinosauridae, so it's very big. It's kind of the opposite. The other one was more Raptor, this one's more Spinosaurid. You know, it's got the multi-uppy-downy sail, as it's officially known, and that very accentuated Spinosaur skull shape as well, and crazy wild teeth. And then this one over here, which I think is my favorite of the bunch, this is the accurate Spino version. So still very much Spinoraptor. It's got the, you know, looks very much like a Spinoraptor, but it's got the sail, and then it's got that big old paddle tail, and it's got a couple little sort of crest things there on the head as well. And then this one, which actually might be my favorite, is the movie Spino version. So it's Spinoraptor, but it's the Jurassic Park 3 Spinosaurus rather than a more direct hybrid. Well, it's basically the Spinoraptor with a Jurassic Park 3 skin, but it looks really cool. I'm a really big fan of this one. And you could kind of use it as a baby Spinosaurus if you were that way inclined. Look at them all, so varied and different. And again, you can put them all together and in a science facility and show it as a testing process between all these different species being melded together. I think it's really cool. So shout out to Mitchell Productions for that. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is your lot. 2 packs here, 2 packs for the decorations, and then 4 new species, 8 mods in total. So shout out to Hassan Wackatree, David, Hawkal1215, Chocolate. I mean, shout out to Chocolate in general, you know. Big ups. Mitchell Productions and Scary Face for yet more fantastic mods. Right, thank you so much for joining me. If you enjoyed this video, please throw me a like down below, but also go, let's try that again in English, shall we? Also go into the mod pages, give them some love, especially if you download the mods and you enjoy them. You know, again, these were all made for free and given out to the world just because these people are cool, basically. Well, they might not be. Some of you might be evil mod makers. Kaio, I'm watching you. But they're probably cool people. So thank you for joining me. Cheers, much love as always. Bye-bye. Rainbow Road.